name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, Lord, we pray, that being rightly conformed to the paschal mysteries, what we celebrate in joy may protect and save us with perpetual power. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The apostles and presbyters, in agreement with the whole church, decided to choose representatives and to send them to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas. The ones chosen were Judas, who was called Barsabbas, and Silas, leaders among the brothers. This is the letter delivered by them. The apostles and the presbyters, your brothers, to the brothers in Antioch, Syria, and Cilicia of Gentile origin, greetings. Since we have heard that some of our number, who went out without any mandate from us, have upset you with their teachings and disturbed your peace of mind, we have, with one accord, decided to choose representatives and to send them to you, along with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, who have dedicated their lives to the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we are sending Judas and Silas, who will also convey this same message by word of mouth. It is the decision of the Holy Spirit and of us not to place on you any burden beyond these necessities, namely, to abstain from meat sacrificed to idols, from blood, from meats of strangled animals, and from unlawful marriage. If you keep free of these, you will be doing what is right. Farewell. And so they were sent on their journey. Upon their arrival in Antioch, they called the assembly together and delivered the letter. When the people read it, they were delighted with the exhortation, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Alleluia.
My heart is steadfast, O God, my heart is steadfast. I will sing and chant praise. Awake, O my soul, awake, lyre and harp. I will awake the dawn.
Alleluia.
I will give thanks to you among the peoples, O Lord. I will chant your praise among the nations, for your mercy towers to the heavens and your faithfulness to the skies. Be exalted above the heavens, O God. Above all the earth, be your glory.
Amen.
I call you my friends, to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment, love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Remind you all that you have to sit where there's a mark on the pew. And of course, if you're married, you can sit next to each other. But also at communion time, I can only give you a communion in the hand. Those are the rules the bishop has set down for us if we're going to have any masses at all. So please try to adhere to them as best as you can, because otherwise we'll have to be closing up the church again, and I don't think any of us would like that. The greatest love anybody can have is to die for a friend. There was a prisoner of war that slipped away from a labor detail in Auschwitz, a Nazi concentration camp in southern Poland. In retaliation, the Nazis picked 10 prisoners at random to be killed. One of the prisoners was the father of a family. As the guards marched the victim off to execute them, a Polish priest named Maximilian Kolbe stepped from the ranks and volunteered to take the man's place. The Nazi officer in charge was stunned, but he recovered his composure and said, "Accepted." With that, the priest marched off to his death. The question for us: what is the greatest sacrifice we ever made for someone we never even knew? Mother Teresa once said, "At the hour of death, when we come face to face with God, we're going to be judged on love, not on how much love we have done, but how much love we have put into the doing." Let us pause now to offer our petitions to our Father.
This Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Maria Salazar. For this intention, let us continue to pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church, the body of Christ, may the Lord continue to guide and sanctify us in his saving work. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our public officials, may the strong hand of God assist them in using their talents for the betterment of all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen ill or have died from the coronavirus pandemic, as well as those protecting the health and safety of others, tending the sick and seeking a cure, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all unborn children, that our love for them may keep them safe until the joyous day of their birth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our men and women in uniform, may they be protected in their time of need, and their families sustained in these uncertain times. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in this faith community, may the love of Christ infuse our hearts and conform us evermore to his ways. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faithful departed, including Pat O'Day, for whom Our Lady of Grace candle burns this week, may they now rejoice with the angels and saints for all eternity in God's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our personal intentions, let us pause in silence. For all of these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an end to abortion and euthanasia throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And that politicians may not use this virus that's scourging our world as a political tool, but instead may unite together for the benefit of our country and our people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Almighty Father, we ask you to hear the prayers which we bring before you humbly, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
And the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of the Church.
Graciously sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray, and accepting the oblation of this spiritual sacrifice, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body,
which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, in thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope, with Oscar, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
In this name. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, and the soul shall be healed.
body of Christ. The 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 body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth and charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Jesus, Lord of the harvest, the love of us, the sweet dream, that satisfies the solid sea, the poor priest, the images, the spirit of the people, to the
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,